Once I finished medical school, I actually decided to take a year out before starting my job as a foundation doctor. And it turned out really well, actually, because the medical school were looking to start a new project, designing a virtual work experience platform as part of their Widening Participation initiative. And they actually asked me if I could do it. And obviously, I said yes. I thought it would quite suit me. I worked in Widening Participation as part of BrightMed for several years, and I understood what they were really trying to do. So I thought that would be a good thing for me to do, and I said yes to doing it. And I planned the project over the course of a year. I researched sort of interesting and also interactive ways to try and deliver virtual work experience, which wasn't an easy thing to try and imagine to do. And then at the end of that year, I had a first sort of prototype of a virtual online work experience course, which could be accessed by anybody, or theoretically anybody in the world who wanted or was thinking about studying medicine. So that was what I did over the course of the year. And I'm so glad to see that its success is being realized now.
We've been completely overwhelmed by the number of users that the platform has attracted. I think we're nearly up to 30,000, which is absolutely insane. It was launched at the end of January, and we had a fairly slow uptake to start with. But kind of as the pandemic really started to take hold, we definitely saw a surge in users. And I assume it's because aspiring medics were searching for other ways to kind of gain insights into the profession. Maybe their in-person experiences have been cancelled, the opportunities for voluntary work kind of diminished, and they're looking for ways to kind of support maybe a future application to medical school, or just kind of, you know, find out a little bit more. We're incredibly grateful for all the support and the promotion that the platform has received from colleagues across the HE sector, particularly Birmingham Widening Access to Medicine Society, as well as school and college teachers, careers advisors. The Medical Schools Council have been excellent, the Royal College of General Practitioners, the Medic Portal, and Barclays Life Skills. Without these kind of real collaborative efforts, we definitely wouldn't have been able to get the reach and engagement that we have. So it really has been a real team effort.
It's obviously just fantastic to see so many people logging in all over the world and engaging in the platform. When I was designing the first sort of prototype of the platform, I really didn't. It's really hard to see what you're making being used by anybody or so many people. To actually see it being used today, and being completed is absolutely phenomenal. And that was what it was all about, really. It was about getting people from all sorts of backgrounds from all over the world, bright, clever, young, ambitious people, to log into the course and to actually find out what studying medicine and being a junior doctor was really about.
I think work experience has always been a topic of conversation amongst aspiring medics. Typically, the assumed kind of prime in-person experience in clinical settings are traditionally accessed much more easily and readily by those who have social capital. And so to be able to offer a resource that could be accessed on the whole by everyone and anyone, I think really went in our favour. We were also able to kind of demonstrate the impact of the programme through analysis of our pre and post course surveys. I think which confirmed that we really were reaching those areas of deprivation, and the course was appearing to have a positive impact.
So in BrightMed, I was involved in teaching and delivering sessions to try and teach people exactly what being a junior doctor would mean and going to medical school would mean. And that meant that I got to speak to lots of young people all the time and find out what they really wanted to know about what going to medical school was like, what being a junior doctor was actually like. And one of the things which kept cropping up was work experience, and they had so many questions about it. And so what work experience was good to do, what was useful, what sort of things should they be learning from work experience, how much do they actually need? And so I got to learn a lot about that.
We're incredibly pleased, actually rather shocked to receive the award. We know there's been a real concerted effort across the university sector, especially during this time where education has been so disrupted, to ensure opportunities, resources, learning materials are available for all, or for as many as possible. Also to learn of the fantastic work that the other finalists in the charity and business sectors have been undertaking in terms of social mobility. We really felt extremely proud, actually, to have our work recognised.
Obviously, I was so delighted to hear that it won the Innovation Award, especially, you know, as part of the UK Social Mobility Awards. It was a competitive award and it was prestigious as well. And to just be nominated for the award was a success, I thought, but to actually win it is fantastic. And I think it's great that the medical school and everyone involved in building that project is actually being, you know, recognized on a national level as to how innovative and how useful and impactful it will be to so many people. So absolutely delighted.